beautiful day in the neighborhood, fam. Friday night here in Maryland. We're in the stand shelter order. This is not Mr. Rogers' neighborhood. This is Rev Kill neighborhood. I ain't even gonna hang this up. Hey, Mom, get that for me. Now, don't y'all try that with y'all moms. Me and my moms, I can do that. But look, y'all, Friday night, we can't come to the church and have Bible study as normal. And so we're here, Rev Kill's neighborhood. And so since I'm not going nowhere, take off the kicks, put on my good slides. Yeah. But check this out, y'all. Tonight's Bible study is very simple. It comes from the book of Deuteronomy, and Deuteronomy, the 31st chapter. And we're going to look at two scriptures, verse 6 and verse 8. Verse 6, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid and do not panic. Moving down to verse number 8. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord will personally go ahead of you. He will neither fail you nor abandon you. Now, y'all, this particular passage of scripture is about this dude named Joshua and Moses. Now, Moses was the mentee to Joshua, and Joshua was the mentor. And so Moses is about to transition as they have to go through something, becomes the new leader. And so what we find are three simple things from Moses that he speaks to the Israelites about Joshua. One, Moses is telling the Israelites, listen, it's time for a change because something is about to come. In the midst of time for a change, he tells the people, Joshua has done great, amazing, and wonderful things. But then he tells Joshua, it's time for you to take the reins and go ahead, and you got to take control and do what you need to do. You all are familiar with the story of Joshua. Joshua leads the Israelites across the Jordan, and God promises him all of this good stuff. But it's a certain TV show that I love, y'all. It's the Jetsons, and then it's the Flintstones. And in this particular passage, in this particular episode, the Flintstones meet the Jeffersons. Now, the Jetsons. Now, you all know they're in two different eras. The Flintstones are in a prehistoric era, and the Jetsons are in a futuristic era. But somehow, their worlds collide overnight. I know you all don't know what I'm talking about, but real quick, look at this quick little set, and I'm going to show you all what happens, and we're going to get out of this.
How's this, George?
A little closer together and relax.
Watch the birdie.
It's only over here. Watch the birdie. Watch the birdie.
Look out. Let's go.
Dino, get over here if you want to get in this picture.
That's okay, Fred. I'll be able to remember Dino without a picture. Hold it. Hold it. I said hold it, not disappear.
Oh, no. The wrong family went back to the future.
Oh, yeah, that had more kick than a Bronto fizz.
Wow, time travel sure must be tough.
Oh, my. Look what it's done to Mr. J.
Yeah, and it sure hasn't helped Elroy and Judy either.
Now, don't panic until I figure out where we are.
Oh, yeah, then we'll panic.
I just did. Fred, I think we just found your strange flying tribe.
I'll tell you what I think. We landed in the future instead of the Jetsons.
Whew. What's good, y'all? It's your boy. I'm here with the Jetsons and the Flintstones. Y'all know when you're traveling, you don't know what the weather's going to be like, so I had to throw on my hoodie because I didn't know what it was going to be like from going from prehistoric to futuristic. But here it is what we're talking about, young folks. In this particular episode, the Jetsons met the Flintstones. Now, we know the Flintstones are from Bedrock. They're a prehistoric group, and then you had the Jetsons were from a place called Utopia. But the interesting thing is their world collapsed in the twinkling of an eye. One night, everything changed drastically for both of them. As you just heard Elroy say, the wrong family went back to the wrong era in history. That's what happened in this book, Deuteronomy, that Moses had to encourage Joshua and all of the Israelites to move forward with a new leader, out with the old and in with the new. Isn't that like where we are right now, that we are in a time where we're out with the old and in with the new? The new is distant learning, distant service, distant worship, social distancing. Everything has been changed drastically overnight. But look what God had to tell Joshua. Look what Moses had to tell the Israelites. He had to stamp Joshua to say, listen, his track history is great. He has what it takes. Y'all just have to hold on, keep the faith, and trust him. But then he charged Joshua to lead the Israelites across the Jordan. And God said, fear not, for I am with you. And then the beauty is, he said, I will go before you. What I want us to know is God is saying to us in this time and era to fear not. God is with us. But here's the part that gets me excited. God is letting us know that he's already gone before us, and we're going to make it through this pandemic. We're going to make it through this time in history, not by ourselves, not on our own accord, but with God. So young folks, fear not. Don't be afraid. I know you may be frustrated of being in the house with your parents. I know some parents may be frustrated of being in the house with their children. But this is the time where we learn to operate in a different manner, but still hold on to God's unchanging hand. Because God said, fear not, I am with you, but I'm not just with you, I'm going before you. God has already cleared the path of how we're going to make it through this pandemic. God is already in May while we're here stuck in April. We just have to hold on to the faith and know that God is with us. Y'all be easy. I'll see you next week back on Rev Akil's Neighborhood. I'm going to hang out with the Jetsons and I'm going to hang out with the Flintstones, and we're going to chop it up a little bit. Y'all be easy. Take care.